Welcome to the Gamescape, everybody. My name is Jarek, and today we're back in Phoenix Point with our playthrough. This is episode 15, and in our previous episode, just a quick recap, we had finished the Overrun mission, and we had also destroyed Pandoran Lair, and so we took this guy out here. So we did both of those. We got a little bit beat up. We've got some troops that are soldiers that are hurt pretty bad. We've got a couple of promotions, and we've got this Barath here that's on a supply run. We have been harassing him with our interceptor Manticore. So we're a little bit beat up. We're going to be heading back here to Phoenix Bravo just to rearm and repair real quick. It won't take very long at all. And then we're going to get right back on him. We just about have his tick launcher destroyed. We'll be able to get it the next round. And then once we have that destroyed, then we'll focus on the body of the craft, because the rest of those weapons we can just dodge with our afterburner. So that's kind of what we're going to do. So we have this other Pandoran lair that we discovered when we saved the New Jericho Haven. And we're going to have to take care of that pretty quick. But I'm thinking today what we're going to do is we're going to get everybody back to get all of our wounded soldiers back to Phoenix Point and get them healing. We're going to pick up another squad, and we might swing down and take care of this Catacombs of Despair mission and start that storyline going too. So I think that's what we're going to do today. And on the way, I'm going to stop and I'm going to grab this assault troop because we need to start building up our third team, because we've got our other Manticore in production. It's not quite up yet because we're working on this Nomad. I want this second missile launcher for our interceptor because the cannon is shorter range. It just doesn't do quite as good of a job, I don't think. And so we got about 5 hours left on that. That should be ready to go before our interceptor is done rearming and repairing. It did take just a little sliver of damage there, and the modules are about half strength from that hit. The hit that we took from that tick launcher. So it's okay. It won't take very long. Like I said, I think we can get right back on this guy and start harassing him. And hopefully once we get rid of that tick launcher, we should be able to take him down. So hopefully one more strike and he's gone. And that should hopefully send the behemoth packing for a little while. Getting rid of these guys tends to up the disruption on these guys pretty fast. So I hope it's going to be enough. We're going to find out. I don't know for sure. So, all right. So first things first, a little bit of housekeeping. We have some research going. We've got mutation technology going, and I want to let that finish before we get the Pandora virus going. But we did pick up sentient AIs from the Synhedrion here. And so I'm going to get that queued up, and I'm going to push it not to the very top. You know what? Yes, I am. I'm going to leave it there. Because what this does for us is it increases our research output by 50%. So this is just accelerating everything. There's no reason not to do this right now. So that'll cut this down to about 12 hours or so once this is finished. So it's going to work out just fine. And then we can start working on some other stuff. Just a few other things that I was looking at that we're going to probably want sooner rather than later. We might go for the priest class. I don't know yet. We'll see. Disciples of Anu equipment, probably too, because they have, I really like their acolyte armor because of the speed boost that it gives. If you have the torso armor and the leg armor, it's +3 to your speed, which is pretty nice. And it's almost as solid as the Odin. I think it's 18, 20 on the torso, 18 on the legs, I think, instead of 20 and 20. I don't remember right off the top of my head, but it's something close to that. It's pretty good. Plus the +3 speed is really nice. So we might go for that. Advanced melee weapons, not terribly interested in that just yet. New Jericho combat armor, we're going to get eventually. I don't need it yet. Neuro implant technology would be nice for the Fury launcher to get on our heavies. That's a nice little extra option that they have. Laser weapons, we definitely want. Neurotoxin weapons, we definitely want, because we want to start capturing Pandorans. We definitely want the infiltrator class. I love infiltrators. They're really fun. Advanced bionics, I don't do a lot with cybernetics. Usually they're expensive material wise. But the other one that I saw down here, light sniper rifles. These things are really nice. They do 90 damage, and they have really good range, and they only take 2 action points to fire. So I actually kind of prefer these to the regular sniper rifles because you can fire them a lot more often, especially with quick aim. You can pop off 4 shots of these things in a round if you need to. And so we'll probably end up picking that up too at some point. The reverse engineering on this stuff is not worth the time. Don't do it. We could just pick this stuff up with the actual regular ANU research, and it's quicker to do it that way. So anyway, that's kind of a look ahead to kind of what we got coming up and kind of what I want to get. But we're going to get the sentient AIs going. Then we're going to get mutation technology going. We're going to get a mutation lab so that we can start getting a mutagen economy building, so we can start looking at mutoid soldiers here pretty quick. And so that's going to be good. We're going to need the Hera from the neurotoxin weapons. So this one will get us the Hera. There's another one that gets us the sniper rifle, which is later on down the road probably. But anyway, that's kind of what we got coming up. We got a decent amount of tech and resources, so if we needed to, we could manufacture some goods, but I don't want to put it ahead of the rest of this stuff, so maybe we'll just hold off on that. So, all right, let's get these guys back to Phoenix Point. All right, and our interceptor's here. It's rearmed already, and it's going to repair for just a little bit. Oh, no, we don't want him to move. There we go. We're just going to finish our move here. Here we go. All right, so they're going to sit there, and let's look at who we've got available. Ernst actually got a promotion. I was looking at him, and I clicked on him, so his little indicator there isn't showing up, but he did get it. So a couple of things we could do. We could go Master Marksman right now, which wouldn't be terrible, or we could dual class him, which also wouldn't be terrible. He's got a couple of traits or special abilities here of his own that would mix really well with the heavy, with the close quarter specialist to make him a really good melee combatant. And he's got the biochemist, which if you pair that up with a machine gun is pretty gross. The problem that I have with that is that there isn't much in the heavy class that helps the sniper. You'd get a lot better synergy going with the assault instead. So I'm a little on the fence. An assault can still do okay as melee, because with the shotgun proficiency and 20% accuracy, it's not terrible. You don't get the extra damage though, which is not so great. But so I'm a little on the fence whether I want to try that. But I don't know. For the moment, it's 20 to get Master Marksman. That would put us at 45. And we could still multi-class him if we wanted to after that, but we wouldn't really be able to buy anything after that. So I guess the question is if we picked up the Assault second class, are we going to get anything out of it? So we take this for 50. That leaves us 15. We would be able to pick up the first ability or the second ability, but not both. Not without dipping into the pool anyway. So we'd be able to get dash, or we'd be able to get return fire. I don't know if we need either one of those, especially. Dash would be nice to get to better positions to fire your sniper rifle, but it's not really super necessary. So I think what we're going to do for right now is we're just going to go with Master Marksman. We're going to save the rest of those points. Master Marksman definitely helps him with the sniping and the role that he's currently in. I don't think we need to rush into dual classing this guy. So we're just going to leave him there. And then he's getting off the plane because he's hurt really bad. Well, pretty much everybody here is hurt. I even also got a level up. So he can get ready for action, which we probably want. He's still also not ready to dual class just yet. He's got biochemist. He's got strongman, heavy weapons proficiency with 20% accuracy, 2 strength minus 15 perception. We could go heavy with him, I guess. And this would help out his accuracy on his machine guns and his, cannons. I think we're going to wait on that too. I think we're just going to pull in ready for action. and wait just a little bit and see maybe if we get something else opened up or see if something else comes up that we need to kind of consider. So we're going to just wait on that. Okay, so he's all taken care of. Get off the plane, go to the hospital. Camila is actually okay, other than a little bit tired, but she's not even bad. She's got 26 stamina yet, so not a problem there, really. Ballas got beat up really bad. He's going to have to wait, too. So, that being the case, what we want to do is we want to strip the gear off all of these guys. This will just take a minute, guys. I think that's all of them. Yep. All right. So now we need to decide who we're going to put on the plane. Right now we just got one heavy. We're going to want probably a second heavy. And so who's ready to go? Eden is ready to go. Mike is not quite. He's still healing. Luis is ready to go. Rena is just came off the plane. So let's go with Eden, I think. Luis has a little more health. Let's take a look at him. So he's 20, 10, 14 at level 4. Eden is 18, 8, and 14 at level 4 as well. So Eden's actually quite a bit behind Luis in his stats. So I think we're going to go ahead and bring Luis out. We're going to get this gear off of him because that stuff is garbage. All right. So instead of that, let's go here, 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 and here. And then you might end up being stuck with your... Who's got our tear cannon? Oh, I bet you Matilda has it. Or not Matilda. I bet you Camila has the tear cannon. She does. Okay. That's fine. Eden, you can just have your machine gun. That's okay. Okay, good. Not Eden. Luis. Luis is who we want. There we go. So you just need this and one of these. That puts you overweight just a little bit. You're nowhere near multi-classing. You can bump your strength one more. That'll put you even with carry capacity. Okay, looks good. Let's get you on the plane. We need Rebecca, I think, is ready to go. Let's get her on the plane. That's one. Turl is good to go. Let's get him on the plane. That's two assaults. Do we have any snipers available? Citizen Eileen, but she's only level 2. Fabiana's level 3. How's her stats looking? She can pick up. Yeah, she can pick up quick aim. She doesn't have much for willpower, though. Do we have another option? What's Citizen Eileen look like? She doesn't have level 3 yet. Her stats are better, though. Ernst just came off the plane. So did Matilda. They're both hurt. Well, I guess it's going to be both of them. We're going out with a little bit greener of a crew than normal, but that's okay. I think we'll be all right. All right, Camila, you're geared up. So is Luis. Rebecca, you need gear. What do we got for helmets? You get one of these and this and this and this. And you get a bulldog, extra ammo magazine. You're going to have handgun just in case. You're going to have a grenade. You're going to have a med kit. You're going to have a second med kit. You don't have ready for action yet, so you'll have to take an action to switch those out. You know what I'm going to do? Actually, I'm going to swap those around so that the med kit's on the ready bar. Needing to use the handgun is sort of a last resort. So that's going to be just that, just a last resort. Okay, Turl, same idea. You're going to get one of these fancy helmets. You're going to get, not that, Odin armor, blast vest. You're also going to get a bulldog. I think we had two. Yep. Extra magazine, med kit, grenade, handgun. Do we save the handguns actually for our heavies? How are they looking? Camila could use one. We have one Hephaestus, but we're going to give that to one of the snipers. We have a second sniper that's going to need a handgun. We have this Udar, which is, I guess, okay. I mean, this isn't really anything that we're going to hopefully have to use to begin with. If we have to use it, we have to use it and we have it, but it's not something that we're hopefully going to be banking on. That's more of a, just in case we get an arm disabled or something like that, measure. So, okay. Camila, you're just not going to have one. That's fine. All right. So Turl is geared. Eileen, you get the Banshee helmet. And you're going to have, what do I have for sniper rifles? I think I have two Firebirds, don't I? I do. Extra magazine. You're going to get, I'm going to take this from you and give it to Eileen because she can actually use it. I don't think you need extra ammo for that. How many rounds does that have? 8? We have the weight. Let's do it. I need a med kit. Maybe 2 med kits just for good measure. That's going to be it for you. And then Fabiana, you're going to get the Firebird. You're going to get the Hephaestus. Extra magazine. The Vestas has 22 rounds. I don't think we need to carry an extra magazine for that. You're going to have a med kit. You're going to have another med kit. And you need armor. So you get the good helmet. You're going to get Banshee armor, Banshee legs, blast vest. You get blast vest too. That puts you over. Get rid of the extra magazine for that. And then you are just over one. You could, you know what you could do? You could just do this. Let's do 17 strength on you. That works. Okay. And that's it. So these guys are all ready to go. Everybody's on the plane. Camila's got a little bit of a stamina issue, but she's not too bad. So we're going to be okay there. We're going to stop here. We're going to hire this guy right here. And if we have to, we can even just get the food from the Haven here. And we're still on our other Manticore. We're still healing up. Haven was destroyed. Can't do anything about that. Okay, we're back. Do we have our missile done yet? We don't. How close is that? Oh, it's 1 hour away. There it is, right there. All right, so now we're going to go Air Force. We're going to go to the Manticore 1. We're going to replace the cannon with another missile, and we're going to go after this Barath again. Okay, Haven info. 336 food, we have that. Level 2 assault train, assault soldier. We're going to recruit him. We're going to send him to Phoenix Point. Good to go. And then we're going to here. Do we just get new recruits here too? We did. Amelia El Masri, cautious, reckless trooper. That's, if she was an assault, that would be a lot better. Close quarter specialist, trooper, and thief. For a heavy, that's not bad. It's not bad. 275 food, which we don't have, but we could get it. We're here. Trade, we can just, I don't have much food. It's not quite enough. We can go here. Okay, Odin grenades done. So we're back to building the Manticore. That's good. We're going to engage. Going to intercept this aircraft again. Should be able to kill it this time, guys. Let's see what we can do here. All right, let's get it targeted. Q5W on 5. We'll blast this tick launcher. In fact, yeah, you know what? I'm going to use both missiles just to make sure we get it. Because he's going to do some shooting at us first. And that should both go, so let's do that. And if we have to, okay, we got it. So now we're firing at the, now we're firing at him directly. We got, taking hits on him. Our afterburner wasn't quite ready to go there. Okay, 360 left. We're in good shape. Ooh, those just barely missed us. 90 left. One more volley. Ooh, that was quick. Time's up. You're dead. All right, so hopefully this will be enough disruption to send the behemoth packing for a while. We'll see. We get 300 materials for that. Everybody's a little bit happy. Looks pretty good. We took a little damage to our afterburner, but other than that, not too bad. All right, so disruption. Oh, no, not even close. That's 3 disruption out of 7. All right, so that's fine. We're just going to head back over to here. And here, we need just a little more. We can trade some of our materials, some of our tech for some food. Actually, we want you, well, they don't have any food. Do we want to change? Yeah, we want tech. We're swimming in tech right now. Let's get some materials. It's a really good trade anyway. All right. Okay, and we're here. We're rearming, we're repairing, and we're going to get down to this mission here, guys. All right, we've found some kind of Pandoran colony strewn with Arthron remains. There's an abandoned scarab outside. We're going to enter the tunnels. All right, let's give these guys just a real quick once over just to make sure everybody's good to go. A little overweight there. We can lose a med kit. We've got quite a few between all of our other soldiers. Good there, good there. You could actually pick up that other med kit. Good there. Good there. All right, guys, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and get us into the mission, and I will bring you back as soon as the loading screen is finished. See you in a moment. All right, guys, we're here in the mission. We're in the tunnels. As expected, we've already got eyes on an Arthur on Scourge. This is just a secure the area mission. Nothing too fancy about this one. Okay, we're going to try this. Destroyed his gun. That's not too bad. All right, let's shift you over to the side here. Rebecca. Not bad, but I think we can get a little better. He doesn't have return fire anymore, so we can get right up on him here. Good enough. Right, that's that. We're at the edge of the map here, although it looks like it goes this way, so we're going to continue this direction. I'm going to get Thrill here. Here? Can't overwatch if I bring him here. How about we bring him to here? And then we do an overwatch kind of up this way a little bit, just in case something comes around that corner, get a chance to blast it. Okay. Luis, you're going to be slower. I want you moving up. Let's go. Okay. And then let's have Eileen. Well, you're not in a bad spot right where you're at here. What if we just did this? What if we just do that and then we bring Fabiana here and then maybe do just a pistol overwatch back this way too. She doesn't have as good of a line of sight there, but that's okay. Just have a little rear guard there. We don't know who's coming from where. Oh, good overwatch. Didn't really hurt him though. We're going to take some hits here. Oh, maybe not. Oh, we got lucky there. He's big. He's got lots of armor. Oh, come on. You got to hit those. That was a gimme. That's okay. We're all right. We'll be able to kill him easy enough. He's not very tough, I don't think. Just have to mine that grenade launcher, and he's hopefully not going to get a chance to use it. So, well, it's thinking about it for a while, though, isn't it? All right. I'm gonna deal with him. We are out of his return fire range, so let's do that and just flatten him. Nice shot, Eileen. All right, you're gonna come around the other side of this cover here just in case. All right, so now what about this guy? We have Shield Bearer Champion. You got weak armor anywhere? Arm. Legs are only 10. He's got still 308 health though, but that's okay. We got a bunch of guys standing right next to him here, so What we're going to be able to do is take his arm out, and that'll get rid of his shield. And that way everybody's going to have shot that. Actually, we may not even need that. We're going to go ahead and take his leg out too. That almost killed him right there. All right, so let's get Rebecca to here. Get eyes up this tunnel a little bit. Make sure no other surprises are coming our way here. Let's have... I kind of almost want Fabiana being our rear guard since we don't have one right now. Let's get her back on her sniper rifle though. Where's the best way to do that? Maybe we bring her to here. I'm just going to do a free aim down this other hallway here. I want to see what our shot looks like. Yeah, it's pretty good over her head. I don't think we're in any danger of hitting her. I think we're okay there. So. I'll go ahead and take that. She's out of movement, so I can't move her out of the way, unfortunately. All right, that's fine. We're just going to have Luis come up here and bash this guy. We could even just let him bleed out, but that's okay. Okay. All right, you are going to overwatch this way. Maybe not too far. Yeah, that's pretty good. All right, everybody else is moving up. Let's go here. Sorry, just looking for a good place to put them. Let's get you into cover over here. You're good there. That's it. Next turn. This would be a nice mission to have a capture team on, but we don't really have the weapons to do a capture team yet. Oh, that was poor. Got two of those guys back here. Not sure if they're both have the virus rifles. He seems like he's already done. Maybe he's not. Find out in a minute here. There's still a bunch of stuff somewhere moving around because it's really thinking about this for a long time. All right. Okay, you're moving up. I think we're going to stick you in the corner here. Okay. Where are you at for... You got one shot. Now I'm going to have to pull you back because you're going to panic. So let's take your one shot, see if we can kill this guy. We're not going to kill him. They both have... they both have the virus rifles. Okay, that's all you're doing. You're going to back up. I'm going to put you here so that even if you do panic, you're not going to go running out into the line of fire anywhere. All right, let's pull Fabiana back to here. And keep that rear... you know what? I'm going to hold off on that. All right, let's have Camila step out here. And blast this guy. I'm going to wait for him to lean over to our right there a little bit. Maybe we get just a little better shot on him. There we go. Yeah, we hit him once. Got him dazed. That's good. Okay, let's pull you back. My turn. All right, Luis with the machine gun from downtown. Let's see if we can get anything done here. Nope, not even one hit. That's okay. All right, what do we got here? Assault rifle. Lining up a shot. Not quite. Okay, let's back you off, get you out of line of sight. All right, and then all we have left is our Overwatch. We're going to do that. All right, let's find out what they're going to do to us here. The nice thing is the Redeemers are, they're an annoyance, but you don't have to worry too much about them actually killing you with them. They do a little bit of damage, but not very much. They do like maybe 20 damage per hit or something like that. Our armor can absorb that for the most part. That might not be exactly right, but oh, here comes another contestant. Got paralyzed damage now. Is he gonna bleed? No, he's not. He already would have if he was going to. I heard a Arthron shield there. Uh-oh. Now it's getting... Now we're starting to get some crowding going on here. I step over to there. Actually, you know what might be worth doing at this point is getting up there and war crying. So he could run to here and war cry. I don't think he would get all of these guys though if I did that. 1.5, 3, 4.5, 5.5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.5. I wouldn't get this guy in the back, even if I ran to here. He can't jump any farther than he can run. That's because of the ceiling in the cave. Where's my other heavy? She could move a little farther. She could get to here and war cry. That might be enough. Put her here and cover. Finish him, hopefully kill him. Put her here, war cry. Might not get him is the problem still from here. 1.5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, he's gonna be just out. But we would get three. Well, hopefully we'll kill two of them. All right, let's do this. Let's get Luis over here where he's got okay line of sight. He's still really far away to be making these shots with that machine gun, but... Yeah, we got a few. Okay, he's dangling for sure. Turl can get to here. Turl can get to here. Take his shot on this guy. That's going to be return fire if I don't kill him, though. Could come to here, take his shot. Let's go here, see what it looks like. Oh, more. Yeah, we got another. It's a hitman. He's got the yeah, he's got the Cyclops sniper rifle. That's not good. Alright, let's look here. If I take this shot, he can still move to here. Eyes peeled. Should be able to kill this guy, hopefully. This is saying it's our best bet here. Yeah, we got him. Nice. Alright, Troll gets out of the way. Alright. Rebecca, you're out of willpower. You're going to rest here and get some willpower back so that you don't panic and go running out there. I can get to here, take a shot, and then step back. How are we looking here? That's not bad. Pink Melian. Did that miss, really? Ah, goodness. Okay. Oh, and she can't step back. I thought she could. All right. Let's show them what we can do. I can make a difference. I'm more afraid of the hitman than I am of these two. So I think we're going to step to here and at least get some hits on the hitman if we can. Now only one. And see where he went. Okay, get him out of the way. Pull Fabiana back. And I'm actually going to have her I don't have a good line anywhere. Does she have extreme focus? She does. She can move a little farther and still get she can move to here and get her Overwatch. Okay, I don't want it that far out though. Yeah, no, I kind of do actually. All right, guys, see what happens here. I don't have a rear guard at the moment. A little worried about that. Oh, come on. Oh, he missed. And that time he didn't. That was a miss. That's probably good. That might have killed him. Tyrant coming from the other side. He's not in range yet. Oh boy. That's not what we needed. All right. You need to back off. You're in bad shape. I'm almost thinking the entire group needs to back off. because we have a lot coming at us that we're not really in a spot to deal with. Can I kill him? I can, probably. Get rid of his torso. And then a second shot should kill him. That would get rid of him, but this siren's gonna come around the corner. And psychic scream, probably. And I still have this hitman, or lots of the ghoul. That hitman is back here somewhere still. We hit him and he pain chameleoned away. But he'll be back and he'll be shooting. All right, let's say we take one shot and then we dash. That will get us back to here. That might not be far enough. Well, we could dash. Yeah, that would be one dash. That would be two dashes. We could get all the way back. So we want to do that. Camila. We war cry, we just get this guy, that's it. So if we fall back here, we have some cover. We don't have a lot of cover, and we've got trouble coming from this other way, although it's not a lot. We can deal with him pretty easily, I think. But if we fall back, do we have enough cover to fight these guys in this more confined space? Not much cover. We have this, we have these two here. We could get somebody here for a little bit of cover. We could get somebody here, maybe, not really. I could leave a heavy here and get a war cry off on everybody coming around here. That would help a lot. All right, so let's do this. Let's get Rebecca just one step out for a second. Okay, Luis, you need to run. You're not going to make it. What if I jump you? Jump to here, still have one move, should be able to tuck in there. It's kind of a waste, but it's farther than he can move without doing it. Oh, he can't move because he's got... Okay. Well, you need for sure a med kit. There we go. Make sure we're on the right guy here. Oh, we weren't. Were we? No. I thought for sure I clicked on the heavy. All right. Rebecca, you back up here. That was not good. All right. Turl, you're going to blast this guy. Since he's an easy hit. Disabled his torso and he's bleeding. Ready. What's your shot here look like? Oh, that's the hitman there. He came forward. Does he have regen? No, he has pain chameleon. That's right, he has pain chameleon. If I destroy his rifle, he's not a threat anymore because he's got mist arms. All right, We're gonna take a little chance here. But I want to make sure I get it. Got it. All right. All right. So he's out of it. He can't really do anything to us now. And hopefully he'll run away. Still worried about this siren. But with that gone, him with... Oh, him with nothing. Him with the Redeemer virus rifle. I can kill him easily. If I bring Camila to here, I can war cry the siren. Maybe get him too, but it doesn't matter. So then it's just him. I could even come to here and war cry. That would be fine. All right, so we're going to do that. All right, so I'm going to finish this guy. Okay, done. Okay. Camila, you're going to come up to here. In cover. You're going to war cry. That gets the siren. That's what we need. Okay, siren's not going to be able to hurt us this turn. We have two action points left here. What is, just out of curiosity,
ready to engage.
Shot on him look like? It's pretty poor. With a sniper rifle, we could probably do something there, though. Start hitting him. Do I want to leave Fabiana where she is? She's pretty safe. He's got no weapon. He's clear back here. She's only got two action points. Yeah, I think we're safe enough to do this. Okay, let's get this. Yeah, it's not a perfect shot, but we have about a little better than 50-50 to hit here. Nice. I'll put a little hurt on him right away. All right. Need a med kit here still. Let's just go here. Okay. Med kit. That got rid of some of the paralyze damage too, which is nice. All right, so there's that. You're out of actions. You're out of actions. I think everybody's out of actions. Got one action left here. We don't have extreme focus yet on Eileen, so nothing for that. Gonna have some shots, maybe. Nope. Oh yeah, he moved way too far. He can't shoot from there.
Positioning.
Yeah, get out of now. Everybody's panicking. That's not good.
What's the plan? Hope I don't miss.
Got 220. What's her bash look like? 87 is all. Well, I might have been a little optimistic when I said he can't hurt us. Because he just did a real number. Still not in retaliation range for him. Attempting to acquire Tuckett. He's almost dead. If we can get just a little better angle, how much closer can we get to him? Maybe one step. It's not much. Of course, if I get close enough to him and just kill him, he can't shoot back. He's got 100 points. I can do more than that if I hit all the shots. Oh, what a mess this is. All right, Fabiana did not panic. Yet. Oh, yes, she did. Never mind. She's got some movement. It's showing she has action points, but she can't do anything with them. All right. All right. Got some there, got some here. Matilda can shoot, 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 and bash, and then maybe that's enough. He'll bleed out. She can't war cry. She's got no... All right, 20 on the leg, 10 on the arm, 10 on the misdemeanor arm. We're going to shoot him there because that's his lightest armor. Yeah, this isn't too bad either. I don't think she can kill him with a bash. Oh, it's close. He'll bleed out. Ready. Panicked, panicked. What do I do here? Do I risk it? Come here for the better angle. Or stay here and get the second shot. That's really bad. Problem is if I hit the gun, it's not hurting him. I think we take the better angle and hope and pray. She's got a lot of health. I don't want to evacuate. Well, I mean, we're getting there, but this should kill him. That should kill him too. This is best, I think. Oh, she didn't even come close to killing him. Now, this is bad. Do I evacuate her? Everybody up here's panicked. These guys aren't going to panic just from him dying. That Siren's coming around the corner this turn. She's probably going to kill Turl. If I don't evacuate her, he's going to kill her. Pretty sure, because he could step a couple of steps closer, and then she's taking that machine gun pretty much at point blank range. Her armor's holding up okay. These guys are all going to be recovering next turn. Oh, this is bad. All right. You know what? Let's get her out. This is, we're at damage control time here. Okay. We have Eileen, who has one thing she can do. She can take a shot at this guy. She's not going to kill him. And then next turn, she's going to panic. I mean, don't really know what I'm shooting at here exactly. There's his gun. There's his head. So his body's kind of this way, I guess, kind of facing us. I kill his arm. He still has his blood, or kill his gun. He's still got his blood sucking arms. But he's got regen. Nice. Got his torso. That's something, I guess. This guy is never going to be done panicking. Don't know what that was. See, this is the problem with panicking, is after they panicked, everybody has to recover. And so nobody has any actions except for Eileen, who did not panic miraculously. She's still got 3 willpower points. Or we could take a blind shot at the ping. See what happens. Hit him. I don't think we killed it. It's bleeding again, though.
Let's do this.
Get her out of the mist. There's the siren. Gosh. 23 virus damage. Yeah, a little hit there. Is anybody recovering? What if you war cry? Definitely getting him. Not sure about Siren.
Ready.
Fabian has got actions now. That ghoul's dead. We really, at this point, we're just fighting for now. Oh, who did we lose? Did we lose Turl?
Standing by.
Standing by.
No. Oh, no, we evacuated somebody. Never mind. Turl's still here. Turl. Are you, how are you looking here? I'm curious why I can't see. Okay, I think we're getting actually semi under control here. It's unfortunate I had to evacuate. How far can she move and still fire? Not anywhere that's going to have line of sight.
Targeting.
This isn't the best, but we're going to give it a shot. Better than 50-50 here. All right, good. He's dead. Okay, now, question is, why can't I see the siren? Let's do this. I throw this grenade here. That'll hit the siren. Won't hit anybody else. And it'll clear some of this mist away. Now we can see the siren. Now we can see the siren really well. All right. Question is how do we deal with her? This guy is surprisingly not panicked. All right, head has to go. Three reloads? Nope. See if we can clear a little more of this mist away without hitting one of our people. Okay. How are we doing for will points? You know what? This would be worth taking this shot and killing this ghoul. I don't know if that hit. Did not. Okay. That's all right. Would have panicked her, is all.
Ready.
All right. I can do more damage with four shots from the handgun than I can do with the sniper rifle. No armor on the tail. I'd like to get you bleeding in two spots, probably. Okay. Where did Turl run to?
Ready.
Oh, he's here. He was here. Okay. How many hit points do you have left? 80? I can bash you and kill you.
Attempting to reposition.
Might break my cannon doing this, but... Okay. That's that. Move out of this mist, hopefully. We're going to do... Luis, I don't have anything for you to do right at the moment. Why don't you just recover some willpower? And then Fabiana, you need to get... You can't move. Yes. Please be the end of the mission. Thank you. All right, guys. That was a little bit of a nail-biter there for a minute. A couple level ups. Eileen got up to level 3. And Rebecca got up to level 5, which is excellent. All right, I'm going to take us back to the Geoscape, and I will bring you back in just a moment. Living armor. Alexander Danchev was certainly here, but he must have left in a hurry. There are abandoned items in a chamber, including a remarkable armored suit. It is actually a mutated living organism bioengineered using some unknown technology. It still seems alive and functional. We're going to take everything. All right. Got full suit of armor. And once more into the maze site added. Not only have we recovered living armor, but we found some other location. Found another location that Danchev might have visited. So, all right. Good. Replenish gear. All right, there's that. Once more into the maze. Oh, that's clear over here. It's going to be a minute before we're getting over to there. We can reach here, but that's it. So, yeah, we're not going to get the rest of this for a little while. All right, so we are sort of beat up a little bit. I don't think we have a medical center here. Have living quarters, but no med bay. All right, so back to Phoenix Point, I guess we go. Let's have a look at our level ups here, since we're staring right at these guys. All right, so Rebecca has level 5. She's got 61. She's got Farsighted. She's got Biochemist. Ready for action, maybe? Or do we Out of curiosity, I think we still only have the main three class. I don't think we've researched it anything yet. No, we haven't. So if we multi-classed her, it would have to be probably sniper at this point, or we can wait. What else would we maybe want to do with her? If we multi-classed her something else, what would it be? The only thing we really have on the horizon right now is Berserker, Priest, and Infiltrator. Which I guess is pretty much everything except for the Technician. So would we want to go Infiltrator with her? Probably not. I don't think so. She doesn't have Thief or anything like that that would help her out as an Infiltrator. I think we'll probably just take her down the sniper path too, get her quick aim plus, you know, the other stuff. I think that's what we'll do. Do we do it now? I think so. She doesn't need ready for action necessarily. I think we'll go ahead and do this sniper training, and then we can do extreme focus, or we could dip four out of the pool and get quick aim now. Master Marksman's coming up too. I don't want that yet, but we'll have it soon. I think I feel good about this, so we're gonna do that. Okay, and then we also have Eileen, who is going to pick up, oh, she's got plenty of XP. I guess I didn't even check her, did I? She does have Thief. Now, she would be a good candidate to be an Infiltrator. The Infiltrator Sniper is a really, really, really fun class to have. So I think maybe we'll plan for Eileen to go that direction. For now, we definitely want to pick up this. It wouldn't hurt to have this. It's only 10 points. And then she could use some more willpower because she needs to use that quick aim. I can't go to 12. I can't really even get close to it. Her strength is low. Wouldn't hurt my feelings to bump her strength to 18 at least. Speed could be bumped as well, but I'm not going to dip into the pool for that. All right, so good. So we're going to, you know what I'm going to actually do is maybe just make a little note for myself on her name. And let's just make sure we remember that. All right. So that's going to head back. Where are we at here? We're going to have the Behemoth eat another Haven, unfortunately. We still have the unexpected emergency mission, which we're going to want our A team for. That's another one that's kind of tough. That's, as I recall, that's the introduction to the Asheron and the corruption mechanic. So I think we want to have our good guys, our best team for that. And in fact, what we might do is like we did with this lair. And we might bring the second Manticore in and bring in 8 people on that mission just to make sure that we've got enough to deal with everything they're going to send at us. We could do the same thing. We're getting pretty much ready to take on the Saving Helena mission too. We're getting our soldiers up to where they can start to handle that kind of stuff. That's probably what we're going to end up doing with those. But we're getting up on a little over an hour here. So I think maybe we're going to call it an episode here. But if you've liked this episode, do me a big favor and click that like button for me. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.